Ultimate community, and welcome to Portland, Oregon. Rounding out the last leg of the tour is NexGen All-Stars takes on Portland Rhino. I am Topher Davis, here with my good friend, partner in crime, Jackson Kelsey.
Hello, Topher, and hello, Ultimate World. It's exciting to be here announcing this game. I watched last year NexGen take on Rhino, and NexGen absolutely obliterated Rhino. It was silly to watch. I believe the final score was 15-7. However, this year, Rhino's looking a lot better. At ECC, they had 6 Universe Point victories. They were pitted in finals against Ironside. They ended up losing that game. However, it's been a long time since Rhino has been in a finals game at a preseason tournament, especially this year with all the new national qualifying rules and the preseason actually matters for who gets bids. Definitely a good tournament. So looking for some good things from Rhino today.
Yeah, Rhino's been playing hot, the team to beat in the new Northwest region thus far. Today, NexGen is starting on defense. Rhino is on offense. On that line, we see Seth Wiggins, Cody Bjorklund, Adrian King.
Also Chris, known as the Bruce.
Thank you. We will probably be referring to Adrian King as the Bruce a few times, so don't get confused. Chris Hancock, Tad Jensen, Mario O'Brien, and that is Jeremy Meyer to round out the line.
Jeremy Meyer, he's a new addition to the Rhino squad.
Mario O'Brien bringing the disc up to the brick mark. Eric Johnson throwing the disc all the way out the back.
Rhino comes down in their vertical stack. Classic for them. It's really been the offense that allowed them to abuse the field.
A lot of space on both sides of the field. To start out, they go to Hankey, the nickname for Christopher Hancock.
Cody Bjorklund, he played NexGen last year. He's playing actually against Rhino last year.
Meyer with the disc on the sideline. Takes a dump to O'Brien. And called in, Adrian King toes the line.
Looked like a ballerina. Better keep his foot in.
Great containment defense from NexGen here. Forcing a lot of dump throws, not letting those passes upfield.
Travel called. Taps it in. Seth always trying to do those quick little moves to get an advantage on the other team. Taps a disc in right away, trying to get the upper hand. However, the observer has to call disc in before the play can resume. Only go tight then.
Seth Wiggins played on Rhino last year and way back in 2006, 2007?
2006.
Before.
He's been all around the club scene. He played for Revolver, he's played for Sockeye, played for Rhino. He's won a world championship with Team USA. He also won Worlds with Sockeye. Definitely the most decorated player on the field right now.
On the dump, finds Chris Hancock. Sets Mario O'Brien.
Inside
break to Bjorklund.
Easy inside break. Jimmy Mickle got picked there, trying to guard Tad. Mario O'Brien will be calling Rio, I'm guessing, for a good portion of this game.
It's great to see Mario on the field. We've heard him a lot as one of the NexGen commentators. And there, Bjorklund finds Jeremy Meyer. Will Driscoll on his back. but can't get in front of the disc.
You could see Will Driscoll rolling his eyes at that one. Disc goes up. He just couldn't quite get the position. Nice, strong, strong jump from Jeremy Meyer to maintain position. Didn't allow Driscoll's large frame to get in there.
I'm quite impressed by the way NexGen was able to contain that offense.
Yeah. Rhino, they're really not known for striking deep a ton. They will take their deep shots, but they seem to have a bit more of a methodical offense, running that cutter from the back of the stack all the way to the open space. They've been told that if they're cutting from the back, they need to continue that cut all the way in, and it's almost better for them to go around the dump because they want to keep that space really open. They like having a two-on-two matchup or a three-on-three matchup down the field so cutters aren't clogging. That time it was just a bailout, and Meyer was able to maintain his position and get the first goal for Rhino.
And after the first goal, we see Rhino's defensive line for the first time. Dan Subnick, Riley Minershagen, Matt Malius, Dylan Stanford, Seth Wiggins, and Mario O'Brien in again. And then Ben Laurie rounding out that line. On the pull, Rhino comes down in the zone.
Yeah, it looks to be man on the handlers and then a three-person wall, then one person deep. Now they're going into a man set just to disrupt NexGen's first play.
Philip Haas getting it up line. Up to DiGirolamo. Haas again.
Pick called.
Now that Rhino is back in man, I wouldn't be surprised to see NexGen fall back in their vertical stack offense. Looks like they have Haas with the disc and Tommy Lee as his dump.
And Phil Haas going right away. Ooh, that's nice. Alex Thorne may be small, but he sure can read a disc. He's been playing for, I don't know, since he was about two or three. Probably had a disc in his hands.
We found out that Alex Thorne has the lowest USAU ID number. Of course, he got it when it was the UPA. His is only five digits.
Wow.
I know myself, it's six. The rest of the team, it's six digits. He's been on this field for a long time. And goes up early to get the first goal for NexGen. Game tied at once.
Not surprising to see NexGen huck it on their first point for a goal. They love the long ball. It's been good to them all tour long. And they get their first point off it. NexGen's got to be stoked after beating the world champions last game. Really, team morale is truly at a high for these guys.
Jimmy Mickle with the pull. Tad Jensen in the center of the field. Travel is called.
Nice play from Chris Hancock to maintain possession for Rhino.
Timmy Persons on the sideline. Dumps it back to Adrian King. Goes all the way around to Jensen. Jensen on the sideline. Nice backhand around to Hancock.
Rhino's really doing a good job of swinging the disc. Getting it all the way to the sideline, creating as much space for their cutters to cut onto as possible, keeping that stack on the opposite side.
Wiggins with the disc on the sideline. Gets it around to Jensen. Rhino in a red zone set.
Tad Jensen has an incredible backing it around.
Ooh. Jensen saving the disc from hitting the ground. Inside out break.
Oh.
And a drop right in front of the goal line for Rhino. NexGen has the disc. Jimmy Mickle on the sideline. And he goes deep to Eric Johnson. Eric Johnson going up between two Rhino defenders, making the play.
Looks like we have some sort of call.
Oh.
Eric Johnson finished second in the Callahan this year. Mm-hmm. Not surprising to see him go up and make a big sky.
Observer calls no foul. Eric Johnson has possession of the disc. He caught it just outside his end zone. High count, dumps to Mickle. And Jimmy Mickle
throws it right to Seth Wiggins.
Unfortunate, two goal line turns, and Seth Wiggins goes deep. Timmy Persons and Jimmy Mickle's there, and
Jimmy Mickle gets the D back. Great effort from Timmy Persten. He's always going to put his body on the line. He's the one wearing the orange cap. Never plays a game without it.
And his signature socks over the cleats. Purple and yellow today. He is one of my favorite characters to watch on the field.
Definitely. He's got the most personality of anyone I think I've seen playing Frisbee. Always good for a laugh.
NexGen with their second possession, hoping to get the first break of this game. Driscoll gets it to Mickle on the sideline.
That's not a throw that every player has. That is easy.
And Mickle, another huck, this time finds Matt Rader in the end zone, making it easy.
NexGen gets the early break. They're up 2-1. That's Mickle's second completed huck of the point. We're talking about this on the bus. Jimmy Mickle really has a lot of Seth Wiggins yet to take a sub this game. His fourth point in a row.
Another offensive point for Rhino. We see their O-line, Cody Bjorklund.
After coming off a great tournament at ECC, they really want to show.
Mario O'Brien up to Subnick. Vertical stack in the center of the field. Foul called on the mark. Seth Wiggins with the disc on the sideline.
Not surprising to see Seth Wiggins call a foul. Any sort of contact when he has the disc from the mark, he's going to call that foul.
Jeez. What a throw choice. Couldn't get the dump off and goes over the mark.
That was almost like a sinking backhand, sinking high-release backhand.
Disc goes back to Wiggins. Coming in, stalling six.
NexGen's really tightening down on the dumps. Really difficult for Rhino to get the disc around, although there they do. Get it all the way open to the other side of the field. See how much space that creates. Then Supnik right on the sideline.
They swing it back around. Matt Malius with the shoestring grab. Definitely an emotional leader for Rhino. He plays a lot of big points, but when it's universe point, Matt Malius is the one that's going to be given the sideline speeches, the huddle speeches rather. And there, Seth Wiggins breaks inside to Cody Bjorklund and ties it at twos.
Cody Bjorklund and Seth Wiggins, two University of Oregon alumni. I believe we have four of those on the Rhino roster, not counting the two from NexGen, Dylan Freechild and Camden Allison Hall, who will be joining Rhino after this tour is over, as well as Whitman star Jacob Janin. Rhino, mostly a full roster. In today's game and in ECC, they're missing Jeremy Norden, big handler from Whitman.
I believe they were also missing Chase and Aaron Talbot. Be really exciting to see what Rhino can do when they have their full roster, including their next-gen players. I mean, they made finals at ECC, all Universe Point wins except finals. You got to think that Dylan Freechild, Camden Allison Hall, and Jacob Janin are going to be playing some big roles on this team. Dan Supnik with the pull. Thorne takes it down and centers to Nick Lance.
We see a straight man here.
Oh, I like this matchup. Dylan Freechild marked by Eli Friedman. You know they're having fun out there. Two University of Oregon grads. Chris Kotcher with the forehand huck. Dislocated shoulder and all. Must be feeling all right. He finds the leading goal scorer on tour, Tyler DiGirolamo. NexGen takes the lead 3-2. I am hoping to see more of that matchup, Dylan Freechild and Eli Friedman. Both went to University of Oregon, although they never played together. And they both are products of South Eugene High School. South Eugene, known for pumping out some great college players and definitely some awesome club players. Plus, they're both about 5'10", real springy, real quick. It's a lot of exciting plays from them. Rhino's O-line here, we have Timmy Purston, Tad Jensen, Chris Hancock, Adrian, the Bruce King, Jeremy Meyer, Seth Wiggins, still yet to take a sub, and Ben Laurie.
A lot of quick movement from Rhino. Seth Wiggins gets it back on the sideline. Hammer upfield to Ben Laurie. Quick movement, and Jeremy Meyer finding Tad Jensen. Tying the game back up at 3-3. Rhino still down a break.
Twice on that point, we saw Seth Wiggins throw a scooper over the top, then a 15-yard hammer to an in-cut. It's definitely something that Rhino of the previous 3 years, not counting last year, it's a new element that Rhino has on their team, a player that's willing to throw whatever he wants. I'd say about 90 to 95% of the time it works. He's really a risk taker. He's willing to take shots, and there it resulted in a goal. NexGen couldn't close the gap that Seth Wiggins was creating with his throws. And Meyer throws the nice inside-out backhand for the goal. Yeah.
Defensive line for Rhino down there. We have first-year Rhino player Ben McGinn, Mario O'Brien, Cody Bjorklund, Matt Malius, Dylan Stanford, Riley Minershagen, and that is Dan Supnik with the pull. Offsides called.
Gives us a chance to say the O-line for Next Gen. Going from left to right, we have big old Tommy Lamar, then Tyler DiGirolamo, Jacob Janin, Matt Rader, Dylan Freechild, Will Driscoll, and Nick Lance.
Second pole attempt from Dan Supnik. Nick Lance fielding it 5 yards in his end zone. Side stack from NexGen. And Freechild going deep. Low pass, but finds Will Driscoll.
He's not going to be happy with that throw, but it works.
Janin with the disc. And a hammer over the top. Plenty of NexGen players over there. Will Driscoll catches it over Tommy Lamar.
Almost runs him over. Interesting, Jacob Janin looks off DiGirolamo, wide open up line. He just must not have been feeling that throw, so he elects to throw the hammer over the top. Fortunately, there are three NexGen players. They come down with it. NexGen leads 4-3. On the line for Rhino right now, we have Tad Jensen, Adrian King, Chris Hancock, Cody Bjorklund, Timmy Purston, Seth Wiggins, and Meyer, Jeremy Meyer. I'll get his first name at some point.
Still a close game. Early in the first half. NexGen up 4-3. The pull goes out of bounds. Tad Jensen will take it to the brick mark.
Right now, Rhino is setting up in their classic offense, a side stack with Seth Wiggins at the back. Tad Jensen will be looking to break the mark right away. Alex Thorne is the mark. There's the break from Tad. DiGirolamo with the D. And Tommy Lee puts it big, the hammer, all the way down the field. Oh, the Usain Bolt spike. Double happiness for Tyler DiGirolamo. That's got to be like his 100th D and his 1,000th goal of the tour. I swear he's a stat machine.
And getting under on Timmy Persons. And then Tommy Lee, I think that was the first pass, goes straight for the leading hammer throw.
Not something you see, but we love seeing it.
One of the advantages of being an all-star team, you have people who can make a throw like that.
It's true. You wouldn't, on a normal club team, you know that throw would be frowned upon from the captains if it was a average player on your team. But with the group of all-stars, anybody can throw it deep. Really, no one's going to be mad at anyone for any sort of throw. NexGen gets a break. They lead 5-3. All smiles on the bus after that one.
Now horizontal stack from Rhino. It looks like a lot of handler movement. It goes to O'Brien, Jensen, O'Brien,
looks like they're
Hancock.
Almost running a dominator here. We've only seen Jensen, O'Brien, and Hancock touch the disc. Now a cutter gets it downfield.
Here we go, they've fallen into the more classic horizontal offense, getting it to their cutters.
Adrian King. That's a nice grab from him.
Jeremy Meyer with the disc. Right on that red zone edge. Mario O'Brien keeping possession. Around to Jensen.
Rio is so good at those little breaks. Just steps practically backwards and breaks around. Here's Adrian King right outside the end zone. His patented high-release lefty backhand to Chris Hancock. He's going to be scoring a lot of goals for them as their handler movement was the reason for all that offense on that point.
Seen a lot of different offensive sets from Rhino in this game. Classic center vertical stack, side stack. The first time they've done a horizontal offense and they run it dominating the handlers. Maybe we'll see a horizontal offense again. And now Rhino defense with the disc. Down a point, down two breaks.
The crowd's trying to get into it here. Cheering for their hometown. When I root for the defense. It's like Ben Lowry to pull. I'm interested to see who Seth Wiggins comes down on this point.
Vertical stack. Jacob Janin breaks free. Philip Haas with the disc. Takes a dump to Lamar. Round to Raider.
Oh, he wound up for the hammer.
Raider being marked by Wiggins. That's a good matchup to see on the field. Two dominant players. And another
big hammer. Tommy Lee just not scared to throw anything. And Raider. Definitely not a mental mistake, simply an execution mistake. Thought he had the guaranteed goal. Steps out, not this time. Dylan Stanford brings it to the line, marked by Phil Haas.
Rhino back in their vertical stack on the sideline. Seth Wiggins with the disc around to Bjorklund. And Wiggins calls the timeout. Important defensive possession for Rhino to get a break, to get back into this game. And on the first timeout of the game, we're going to take a break for ourselves. Thanking our sponsors and everyone involved with the NexGen production. We'll be back in just a minute. Welcome back to Portland, Oregon. Team on the rise, Portland Rhino, taking on the NexGen All-Stars.
Seth Wiggins burned that timeout. You can see that this is a pretty big point for Rhino. They don't want to extend NexGen's lead right now. NexGen leading 5-4. Looks like their set play didn't quite work out, so they dump.
Bjorklund, and Bjorklund going deep, looking for Ben McGinn. Just out of reach. And on a defensive possession, Rhino can't convert. NexGen gets a second opportunity to get it.
Surprised Tommy Lee didn't throw a hammer there.
Janin getting the disc on the sideline. Up to Phil Haas. taking the safe dump, pick call downfield.
NexGen's vertical offense is slightly different from Rhino's in that they keep it in the center of the field. They like to have a live side and a dead side to cut on, whereas Rhino really likes to just keep the disc on one side. Jacob Janna not happy with that throw as it was behind Tommy Lee. Matt Malius gets the D.
Minor shotgun on the sideline, up to Malius, just outside his goal line. This is an important possession for Rhino. Malius hammers on the dump. Minor shotgun finds Ben Lurie to get a break back, tie this game at fives.
I wonder if NexGen had a mix-up on the force there. Looked like they were forcing towards the line, towards the crowd, the backhand side, and then that throw, a wide open flick to Ben Lurie. Big point for Rhino. They tie it back at fives.
Rhino's D-line on again. Trying to get another break back. We see Dan Subnick, Ben McGinn, Riley Minershagen. One of my favorite players to watch and play with. Callahan winner, Eli Friedman.
Of course, me and Topher are a little biased. We played with him for years and years. Anyways, continue.
And then rounding out the line, Mario O'Brien, Timmy Persons, and Grant Cole.
Grant Cole, he's a great dump defender. Would not be surprised to see him get a D on this point.
Pull from Dan Subnick goes out of bounds. Alex Thorne is going to take this at the brick mark. Vertical stack from the bus. It looks like a junk set from the Rhino defense. So we have NexGen falling out of the vertical stack.
I really like seeing Alex Thorne pick up the disc right away. Oh, Colin Camp bounces off his hand. He's going to be mad about that. Tapping his chest, acknowledging it was his turn. I really like seeing Alex Thorne pick up the disc for NexGen. He just has such solid breaks, an awesome high release flick, an easy inside backhand that he doesn't pivot on. He may have a short wingspan, but he can really break the mark wherever he wants. Now Rhino looking to get two breaks in a row.
And Subnick going deep to Persons immediately. This is a good matchup. Persons, Driscoll, and Driscoll going up a little too early. Can't get a hand on the disc, and Timmy Persons reels in the second break in a row for Rhino. Put them up 6-5 and get them even on breaks.
That's exactly what Rhino wants. They want Timmy going deep. He gets up higher than anyone else on the team. Probably one of the top four or five deep receivers in all of the Northwest region. I've seen him sky multiple players taller than him. And right there, he skies the taller Will Driscoll.
And a timeout from NexGen after two breaks. They're looking to regroup. We'll be back here in just a minute. And we are live back here in Portland, Oregon. Rhino rolling off two breaks to get back on serve and take the lead again, up 6-5 on the NexGen All-Stars.
This is a different Rhino team than we saw last year at this game. They have a tournament under their belt. They have six Universe Point victories. They came to play. D-line for Rhino is Seth Wiggins, Mario O'Brien, Dylan Stanford, Cody Bjorklund, Minershagen, Supnick, and Malius. Supnick pulls that one out of bounds. Tommy Lee to bring it to the brick.
So far, Rhino forcing some great Ds. The last point, it was just an unforced turn. And now we see a horizontal stack from the NexGen All-Stars.
Lots of zone from Rhino this game. Really wreaking havoc. Right there, Riley with the big D.
Rhino picking it up, looking to attack immediately.
Crowd likes to see that one.
Wiggins to Bjorklund. Melius. O'Brien. Foul called off the disc. Mario O'Brien with possession. Gonna get a full 10 seconds on that one. Another pick in the vertical stack.
Seth Wiggins with that foul call.
Rhino a chance for their third break in a row. The momentum seems to be on their side. Supnik with the disc. Goes around to Stanford. Can't continue to the cone. Takes the reset. All the way across the field. At Wiggins, flipping it to Matt Melius. Three breaks in a row. They're now up 7-6, up a break.
Surprising to not see NexGen take a timeout right here and gather their thoughts. Topher, as you said, that was three breaks in a row for Rhino. NexGen kind of riding a high. They're up 5-4, looking to take the lead, 6-4. They turn it. And then Rhino rattles off three breaks.
Tight game in this first half. That zone from Rhino seems to have been doing pretty well.
Yeah, it's definitely shutting down the cutting lanes for NexGen. Usually they see a zone look for a couple throws. Rhino has been doing the diamond where they stop the initial play, but they have also been staying with that zone some other points, so they're really mixing it up, keeping NexGen on their heels. Here they come down again in a zone.
Much smoother offense. And now Rhino's in their man. Free child with the disc on the sideline.
Moving it very quickly. It's a little too far outside for Driscoll. Looks like it hit his hand.
Not a perfect throw to Driscoll, but certainly a playable throw.
Certainly one you'd think an all-star would be making.
Yeah, again, we're just seeing execution errors from the All-Stars. And Rhino with a defensive possession that could take them into half. Friedman with the disc up to Meinerschagen. Laurie, Cole. Great bid from Matt Rader, but Laurie keeps possession. Friedman on the sideline. And a travel called.
Ben Laurie plants and then hops forward.
Hop, skip, and a jump right into the travel. Leading pass to O'Brien. He's on the goal line. And he's able to flip a push pass to Ben Laurie. Rhino rattles off four breaks. Being down 4-5. Take half 8-5.
There's a lot more energy in this Rhino team this year than we saw last year. Rhino favoring the handler movement for their goals in the red zone. Works out there. Mario O'Brien with the push pass to Laurie. I don't know if NexGen has been broken four times in a row yet this tour. They've been down before at half. At Pony, they were down 8-3.
And maybe not since Pony or their Bravo game. But NexGen has always done a good job coming back in the second half. we're excited to see what kind of adjustments they make, what kind of energy they're going to bring in the second half. And for the 10-minute break here in the broadcast, we're going to take our break too. Be sure to come back. Check us out in 10 minutes to see the exciting finish to this game. Welcome back to Portland, Oregon. Portland Rhino up 8-5 on the NexGen All-Stars. Great run at the end of the first half. Four breaks in a row to take half, 8-5.
Definitely rode their emotions on that one. See if it can translate into a big second half for Rhino.
All-Stars starting off on offense. Seth Wiggins with the pull. Free child on the sideline, facing the zone again. Mikkel with the disc, dumped to free child. Gets the disc over, finds Matt Rader. Jacob Janin able to run that down, and he goes deep to Dylan Freechild. Freechild, plenty of space. Just outside his goal line, flips it up to Jimmy Mikkel.
Nice, easy goal for NexGen to start out the half. A big, big swing all the way over to speedy Jacob Janin. He runs that down, collects himself just for the half a second, and rips a disc all the way down to Dylan Freechild. They did that at South Eugene all high school long. Can tell they've played together a lot. Jacob trusts Dylan deep. He rips it. Not the furthest throw. It was low and where it needed to be, though. Freechild backpedals, finds wide open Jimmy Mikkel. NexGen, easy goal. I think one player that really needs to improve his play right now is Will Driscoll. Two times he got skied down here. Once was by Purston, another time by Meyer. And usually you see him coming down with it no matter who he's going against. I'd like to see big plays from him in the second half. I think if Driscoll can get one or two Ds, I think NexGen can come back and take this game.
Whether it's Driscoll, Johnson, Lance, anyone on this D-line, ooh, Lance going for it.
Callahan Award winner.
Great defensive bid against Seth Wiggins.
Lance on his back. That can't feel good.
King on the sideline. Goes with the backhand of Bjorklund. Bjorklund in a high count, goes deep, going for Jeremy Meyer. Camden Allison Hall can't catch up. And Timmy Persons.
Jeremy Meyer, new player for Rhino. Cutting deep. Looks like Allison Hall just right over his head. If he could have seen that disc a second earlier, you know Allison Hall is going to be making a bid on that play. It was just right over his head, so he couldn't quite lock onto the disc and lay out fully. So Bjorklund to Meyer, Meyer to Purston, who also made a really nice play to catch that disc. Two-handed snag. Rhino doesn't give up a break. They still lead by 3-9-6.
Still early in the second half, and we saw a lot of great energy from the Rhino, from the NexGen defense. That deep look, probably not the option that they were going for, but because of strong dump defense, Bjorklund in a high count situation decides to take his chances far away from him. You don't want to give a short field to a lot of fast, quick movement players.
Tommy Lee takes down the pull and centers to Jimmy Mikkel. NexGen in a horizontal set. Rhino playing zone. Looks like they're about ready to match up.
Allison Hall in the middle of the field. Around to Lee. Allison Hall. Scuba's a free child.
His Oregon teammate. Allison Hall wants that disc in the end zone.
Pick called in the stack. Tommy Lee with the disc.
Looking for a hammer, looking for a hammer. He elects to dump. Another pick. NexGen just a little bit off on their timing of their cuts.
Mickle going deep, Haas is there, and Bjorklund
incomplete. He's patented that move.
Bjorklund having position on the inside.
I'd be really surprised to see Phil Haas come down with that disc. Bjorklund, a huge body, 215-pound frame. Phil Haas, maybe 160.
It's definitely difficult to get around Cody the King Bjorklund. And an execution error from Riley Minershagen.
A little behind Matt Malius. Free child dumps to Haas. Haas with the blade to Tommy Lee. Looks like there was a pick called. Goes back to Haas. Big point for NexGen. They got to convert their O points if they want to win this game.
Reset to Haas.
Cody Bjorklund, second D of the point, again signals incomplete. Rio picks up, marked by Freechild.
And a second execution error from Rhino. Gives NexGen a short field.
Rhino getting the Ds, they just can't convert. He's got to take a little bit more time on their throws. They're looking a little rushed.
Around to Camp. Just outside that red zone line. Freechild getting it upfield. And a low throw to Allison Hall.
Gosh.
Observer calls it up.
Camden Allison Hall. Shoestring grab. Dylan Freechild keeps it about 2 inches off the ground the whole time. And Camden Allison Hall scoops it off. Oh, my. Cartwheels for the goal. Oregon to Oregon right there. We hope to be seeing that a lot in the college season.
That is one of those throws that if this were a grass field, technically it would have hit that blade and observers might have called a turnover.
Just one blade of grass is all it needs to hit.
That one.
Fortunately for NexGen, it's a turf field.
Great grab from Allison Hall.
I love seeing the roll after the point. Camden keeping his legs straight out. Almost barrel roll, cartwheel. Big, big point for NexGen. They needed that one. An O point. They turned it twice. They don't want Rhino to extend their lead any more than three. Nick Lance to pull for NexGen.
Hoping to chip away at this lead. Tad Jensen with the disc. Field to Chris Hancock.
Oh, Tyler DiGirolamo baiting the deep throw. He wants them to throw it deep.
And Wiggins hammers over the top. Driscoll is there.
Oh. Ooh. Through Meyer's hands. Fortunately, Purston's right there. Cleans up the trash. Big pump fake from the Bruce.
Floaty disc. Matt Rader potting out Seth Wiggins to get position. And Seth Wiggins bodying back.
Looking a little chippy out there. Wiggins trying to hold strong, tries to put his butt into him. Rader goes through, almost gets a Callahan. Then Wiggins just runs right into him and pushes him over. Spirits are high, though. Foul, no contest, coming in on zero. Next Gen looking to get their break right outside the goal line.
Violation called. Tyler DiGirolamo on the far left of your screen, unmarked. He's going to get it without any difficulties. Matt Rader making it happen on the field.
He is fired up. Stay on Rader.
Matt Rader.
Known for his enthusiasm. I think we're seeing just the tip of the iceberg, though. I'd like to see him get a big layout D and then see what he does.
Rader, that star from Sockeye. In the Northwest region, he's matched up against this Rhino team plenty of times.
It'll be really interesting to see how Rhino responds after getting broken there. The Rhino of the last 3 or 4 years lost twice in the game to go to Nationals.
Of course.
They were up late in the game in 2010. And last year, they beat Furious 15-9 earlier in the day in the semifinal game at Regionals. And then ended up losing in the game to go to Furious later that day, 15-11.
Of course, if you're interested more in the Rhino story, you can catch their feature film, Chasing Sarasota, also touring the United States. Offense point for Rhino. We see a lot of intensity out of the NexGen defense. Mario O'Brien going deep, and no one is there to receive it.
Looks like he had Eli Friedman. However, they're just not on the same page right there. Friedman goes under, and Rio's throw sails long. Nick Lance brings it to the line, marked by Seth Wiggins.
Chance for another break to tie this game for NexGen.
You can hear some fans in the crowd cheering for NexGen.
Lamar with the disc. And Lamar goes deep, looking for Will Driscoll. Driscoll catching it, and quick, easy up to Jimmy Mickel.
Will Driscoll, great play from him. Good thing he's got about a 6'7" wingspan. Tommy Lamar, not known for his throws, puts the forehand huck. Driscoll reaches out, collects it, gives it to Jimmy Mickel.
Plenty of space in front of Will Driscoll for Tommy Lamar to put it. And after two breaks, Rhino is going to take a timeout, get their heads back in this game. Game is now tied. They want to keep the momentum in their favor. And on their timeout, we're taking a break too. Be back here in just a minute. And welcome back to Portland, Oregon. Exciting action here in the second half as the NexGen All-Stars, two breaks to tie this game, back at nines against Portland Rhino.
This game is starting to look a lot like the game against Pony that NexGen had. They were down at half. They were able to tie it at nines, and then Eric Johnson got a huge layout Callahan to take the lead 10-9, and from there, the bus went on a roll.
Will history repeat itself? We shall see. Defensive line
That's
for next
That's a great shot right there. Sunset and moon.
Chance Jensen in the center of the field. Hanke coming from the front of the stack.
Guarded by Chris Kotcher. Kotcher, I'm willing to bet he is the best one-on-one cutter defender on this team.
And Eli Friedman going deep to Dan Subnick. That's floating. Subnick not able to make up the ground. Tommy Lee walking the disc up, going for three breaks in a row.
Friedman's throw just a little too far.
Johnson unmarked, goes deep to DiGirolamo, running it down, plenty of space. Speedy DiGirolamo.
The bus is rolling. Eric Johnson. Probably some of the most accurate throws you're going to see from a player playing Ultimate. That forehand tuck finds DiGirolamo. He kicks spikes. NexGen takes the lead 10-9. Rhino, what's going on? Took half 8-5. Four breaks in a row.
A few offensive miscues, but a lot of good playing from the All-Stars.
Tell they've ramped it up a notch. After Raider got that big D and he was all fired up, it definitely fed the other players. You can tell they're running just a little bit harder, just a half step quicker.
NexGen captains for the 2012 tour, Eric Johnson and Matt Raider, making things happen on the field. Raider with inspiring defense. Eric Johnson doing it with his throws. And now we see yet another defensive point from the All-Stars. Vertical stack, Mario O'Brien with the disc. Up to Meyer, Bjorklund. And a foul called. Bjorklund trying to go up line to Mario O'Brien. This is being discussed. And foul is taken away.
Not upheld.
Now Nick Lance picking up the disc. Interesting swing to Jimmy Mickle, but it works out. It's Will Driscoll with the disc. Looking off the hammer. Getting up there in the count. Finds Kotcher. Jan in the middle of the field. And Nick Lance ripping a hammer. Oh,
Driscoll so close.
In the hands of Driscoll, but an upside down throw coming hot.
That's a huge turn of events for Rhino. Driscoll catches that. They take the lead 11-9. Now they have a chance to tie it at 10s. Stop the bleeding.
O'Brien with the disc. Up to Persons. Bjorklund. Hammer all the way to the dead side of the field. Opening up a lot of space. Another hammer. And that one floats over Timmy Person's head.
Jimmy Mickle wisely burns a timeout. Leading the tour in timeout calls, Jimmy Mickle. He had three in the revolver game. He's got one here today.
This looks like it's just an injury timeout. Person taking a while to get up. Walking off the field. As we were saying earlier, Timmy Person is a great energy player. A lot of fun to have on the field, but also one of the players who you want there to make some big plays and really fire up the rest of the team.
Athletically, he's just a freak. He puts his body so far on the line. He's 6'2", can jump out of the gym.
fun fact about Timmy Person. In his college days, he was also the mascot for Oregon State. He was Benny the Beaver. You got to think that some of that enthusiasm has translated to Ultimate, getting his team fired up, just being a guy with lots of witty jokes, always there for his team, ready to pick him up.
And finally, disc gets tapped into play.
So there was not a timeout, so that is not a timeout call for Jimmy Mickle.
Nope. Philip Haas with the disc. Second opportunity to break. Mickle finds Lance on the dump. A lot of downfield pressure. Travel called on Freechild.
Took one too many steps there. Freechild marked by his former and current captain, Cody Bjorklund. Bjorklund captains Rhino. And last year he captained the University of Oregon Ego. Rather, 2 years ago he captained Ego.
Freechild getting it up line, but a pick called in the middle of the field. And Freechild going deep to Nick Lance. Nick Lance maybe not expecting it. Coming over his head down that sideline. Unable to make a play on it. And we are getting into one of those long points.
NexGen had a point like this against Revolver. It was 6-6. There were at least five turns from each team. NexGen ended up getting that break. They went on to win that game.
Travel called on Cody Bjorklund.
Crowd doesn't like it. Cody doesn't like it.
Bjorklund directing traffic on the field.
Always a loud voice on the field. His opinion is always known by all the players and observers especially.
Of course, I want to say all the games on the NexGen Tour, but we've had a few games haven't been observed. 14 out of 16 games on the NexGen Tour have observers. Today we have the father-son combination of Patrick and Andrew Buremeyer. After some discussion, just coming back in play. Seth Wiggins.
That's fun.
Leading hammer
really
down
fun.
The sideline, finding Malius. And Cody punches it in, gets Matt Malius.
That is huge for Rhino. Looking at 11-9. Instead, Will Driscoll drops the disc. And Seth Wiggins throws a 60-yard hammer on a dime. Gains a lot of ground for Rhino. And then Bjorklund's able to find Malius with a big hammer fake. Easily breaks his mark. Throws it 3 yards for the goal.
I've got to say, I don't think I've ever seen a game with this many leading hammer throws. I mean, it's one thing to see the hammers go across the field hitting the dead side, but these have been what might have been typically a backhand throw, players just preferring the hammer.
Yeah, they're throwing it to outcuts is the thing. They're not throwing it to the hammer side and the red zone, which is something you often see. This one is to an outcut. Matt Malius just cutting deep here. You got to think that Seth Wiggins is good for at least one 50-yard hammer per game. Tommy Lee, however, I haven't seen that out of him all tour. Coming down in a zone look. Another man. Riley Minershagen just hanging out deep for him.
Raider with the disc. upfield. Kotcher's wide open. And Kotcher going on the backhand, floats it up to DiGirolamo. If it stays in bounds, no.
A little too far. Chris Kotcher wound up and threw it a country mile. I don't think he's thrown a backhand huck in a few games. Of course, he sat out the double wide game with a dislocated shoulder. And then his throws were a little limited in that last game, the revolver game. He did have a forehand hook, however, earlier this game. That one just a little too far for DiGirolamo.
Mario O'Brien tapping the disc on the goal line. Side stack from Rhino.
Dylan Stanford with the drop.
Unfortunate for Rhino.
Alex Thorne's going to pick up Rio O'Brien, and Thorne goes with the hammer. Jeez, that's four. Four hammer hucks. You might see that in a pickup game, in a game at Potlatch. But, well, I guess this is a sort of a showcase game, but I like to think of this as elite club level ultimate, where teams are playing to win. NexGen completing three hammer hucks.
I mean, I guess if you have the skills to throw it.
If you got the throwers and the receivers, put it up. I'd like to see the players make plays. Or as Eli Janin used to say, let ballers ball. That was an 0 point for NexGen. They take the lead back 11-10.
Jimmy Mickle set to pull.
That's going to come off perfectly.
Whew. Middle of that end zone.
I think he might be competing with Brody Smith for maximum time aloft.
Here we see NexGen throwing their zone, which I think we're seeing for the first time today. Just breaking up that initial play. Bjorklund on the sideline to Adrian King.
NexGen now in their man.
Melius Bjorklund. Taking the dump to Jensen.
Tad Jensen throwing to his college teammate, Matt Melius. They played at PLU together. Rhino really doing a great job of swinging the disc, creating space.
We've seen them use the whole 40 yards multiple times, taking it all the way to the sideline line.
That is an incredible break from Tad Jensen. He loves his backhand. Rhino just working the disc. Swing, dump, swing.
And Persons finds college teammate from Oregon State University, Chris Hancock.
Second goal of the game for Hancock. Nice break around, really created by those swings and those dumps.
Great movement from the Rhino offense, tying this game at 11.
That's the thing about the swings. When you swing all the way across the field, and you do that a couple times in a point, it creates a lot of space. So then when you fake a swing, the defense is forced to jump over to that side, which opens up the whole dead side right there, Persons. Able to find Hancock, about a 30-yard backhand break low right on the sidelines. Rhino ties it at 11s, showing some resiliency. they must have learned a lot of that at ECC. Six universe point wins.
Yeah, they're certainly used to playing these tight games.
We were joking around with the Rhino captains before and said that if they get to universe, we know who's going to win. Tommy Lee centers to Phil Haas.
Camp with the disc.
Camp's been playing really solidly the last four games.
Raider looking like he wants to throw that hammer.
Kotcher's just open all over the field. I don't think Ben McGinn has a chance to stay with him. If I'm next gen, I'm looking for Kotcher every time. I guess every other.
Camp with the disc. Looking high count.
Throws it off his back foot with a dime ball to Tyler DiGirolamo. Looks like we have a stall call, however. Right before he threw that forehand huck, Chris Kotcher was streaking wide open 5 yards in front of him. Not a bad play, though. If it's going to be a turnover, you might as well turn it over down at that goal line.
At the 8, 9, 10, Camp just getting it out. Might have seen DiGirolamo streaking deep. And that disc is going to come back. Contested stall. Not a contested stall.
That's huge for Rhino.
It looks like the observer rules it as a stall. Less than half the field to go for the Rhino defense.
Rhino has to get the disc in Seth Wiggins' hands.
Physical bid from Raider. Coming into Dan Subnick's side and a foul is called.
Looks like he's contesting. He doesn't like it. Maybe he's not contesting.
Some discussion. Raider has the inside track.
Lots of contact. I don't think that call. I'm pretty sure it's staying with Supnik. It's got to be staying with Rhino here. There's too much contact on that. That's the thing about Frisbee. Players make their own calls. And if they can't decide on a call, then they will go to the observers. So the people in orange. Father-son combination of the Boermeyers. This stays with Supnik, marked by Raider.
Foul is upheld.
Rhino has to get the disc in Seth Wiggins' hands.
There we have Wiggins with the possession.
It's like a foul call. Supnik with the foul call. Raider talking something over with him. Seth Wiggins really could throw anything right here.
We've seen some great goal line stands from NexGen in the revolver game. Here, Rhino with a chance to break and go up a point. Pick called in the stack, stays at Supnik.
It's really something that NexGen, that helped NexGen win that revolver game was their goal line defense. Being able to really tighten up when you need to. See if crafty Seth Wiggins can get Rhino a goal here. Swinging it around, working it with their handlers. Everyone's moving. Mario O'Brien long jumps 18 feet. Stomps it into the end zone. That is huge for Rhino. They get a break in the second, their first one of the second half after NexGen reeled off three in a row. Mario O'Brien, captain of this team, makes a huge play.
Putting Rhino up 12-10. And a close game. certainly something we might have expected. Rhino playing hot at ECC. They're returning a lot of players from their last year's roster who had a big push trying to get to Sarasota, a team that hasn't been to nationals since 2007.
And the players on this team are very, very different from that team.
Exactly.
I believe there are three players remaining from that team. That would be Matt Malius, Tad Jensen, and Breeze Strout.
Seth Wiggins was on the Rhino team that made it to nationals in 2006.
Centering to Nick Lance. A little bit of a miscommunication there. Nick Lance didn't quite read Freechild's cut. Tries to hit the around. Bjorklund runs through. Tommy Lamar with the D. And Dylan Stanford with the catch. We need to see this again. Bjorklund with the D just runs through on Freechild's cut. Then Tommy Lamar. Oh my, our camera's so close to catching it.
There's discussion downfield. I don't know what the players are talking to the observer about. If there's a foul on the throw, it wouldn't matter as the catch was still completed.
It looks like he gets that. He scoops the disc. The edge doesn't touch the ground. Topher, like you were saying, if it's a foul called and the player catches the disc, then it play results in a goal.
Then it must have been called a down disc as Seth Wiggins has possession. So Stanford not able to pick it up off the ground.
Our cameras didn't quite capture that. They were close from that camera angle. Looked like he did. And Bjorklund trying to lay out. Rhino captain going to Rhino captain. Doesn't work out.
Thorne tapping the disc in. NexGen moving it around quickly, switching fields.
Tyler DiGirolamo with the hit. Oh! No!
Thorne trying to make the jump into the end zone.
You got to think that NexGen's going to turn that over eventually. It's worked too many times for it to not turn over. Hit him right in the breadbasket, though.
Unfortunate play for Thorne.
Thorne buries his head in his hands.
Oh. Would have been huge. And Tyler DiGirolamo.
What is that, Supnik? What was that throw? It looked like it was hand blocked or something.
I don't know. Supnik going for the scuba break. Has to bring it up over the defender's hands.
Not something you want to throw at this point in the game.
NexGen gets a lucky break.
Thorne catches that one with a break to Tommy Lamar. Supnik's calling a pick. So disc is going to go back. The thing that I'm confused about is if Supnik has this much space, how is it not a goal? That easy for NexGen. Alex Thorne is not going to miss that throw. He's got the best breaks. Him and Nick Lance are pretty much tied for best breaks on the team in my book. Right there, NexGen gets a big, big break for a goal.
Short field turn for NexGen. Again, we were talking about that strong goal line defense on another leading hammer. They can't get it in. The next pass, Tyler DiGirolamo makes a play. And being that close to the field, NexGen is not going to miss it. And again, we've seen that leading hammer all game. Doesn't work that time. But hammers.
Hammers and hammers. I think we're in double-digit hammers right now.
Of course, and not always working out for the teams.
And five of them are hucks. That is crazy. Looks like a team burned a timeout here.
timeout. I'm unsure who called it. Either team tied at 12 could have taken that timeout. Coming in late in this game, both teams hoping to find the energy that they need to really rally off these next 3 points.
12-12. This is huge for both of these teams. It means a bit more for Rhino, I think, because they're really trying to prove themselves as a club team. This is a team that's going to compete in the Northwest region. Depending on how many bids are given to the Northwest, this is a really big game for confidence, to proving to themselves that they are competitors, that they can compete with the best in the world. NexGen, they don't want to lose to anyone.
After coming off a big win in San Francisco, it would be a letdown to come up here. Granted, Rhino has been practicing in their season. They came ready to play at ECC. And in the middle of the season between ECC and Labor Day, of course, they are looking top form.
There are going to be some big plays on these next few points. You know players are going to be throwing it all out there. Starting things off, Jimmy Mickle rips an enormous pull.
Lots of float. Defense is already set on the vertical stack as the disc comes into the hands of Mario O'Brien. Hancock throwing it upfield with the body.
The bodies hit the floor. Jeez, flying all over the place. Nick Lance loving that Seth Wiggins matchup. You really can't stop Seth. You can only hope to contain him.
Movement from the handlers. Nick Lance.
Hello, I want a Callahan Award. Thank you. Incredible D.
Allison Hall up to Freechild, and Freechild doinks it. Goes for the one hand. Tyler DiGirolamo trying to keep him fired up.
I hate saying this, but Dylan Freechild has made it a theme this tour of dropping discs. You know he is kicking himself right now for dropping that one.
Pick call downfield. Adrian King with the disc being marked by Jimmy Mickle.
Lots of physical play. Jimmy Mickle all smiles down there, talking it out with the Bruce.
A heated battle, 12-12 late in the game.
Lots of calls and this game.
Yeah, calls are gonna start happening.
A grimacing look from Freechild and DiGirolamo.
Disc is back in play.
Seth Wiggins with it. It's exactly what Rhino wants. Sure-handed Bjorklund receives that. It's going back. Pick called.
Back in play. Jeremy Meyer catching it right in front of Mickle. Pick called, continues all the way to Wiggins. Doesn't affect the throw to Wiggins, so he's going to keep possession.
Wiggins just never stops. He hears a play call. He's still trying to get that extra throw off.
Three, And Wiggins going deep.
Chris Hancock puts it out there. Hancock, third goal of the game for him. Not something you're ever going to see from him. Going deep. Seth Wiggins realizes that Camden Allison Hall is about 10 yards behind him.
And the crowd loving the Chris Hankey goal. Giving a let's go Hankey.
Rhino's feeling it right now.
Rhino's doing well, and a lot of support from the Portland community here tonight. They are excited to see Rhino really make a name for themselves on the national stage. A great Ultimate community here in Portland. A lot of players in the city involved. And here at 13-12, tight game. I believe we are on serve since the beginning of the game. And NexGen is going to need to stay calm, put in a point, and get a break back to take advantage. Coming out against the zone, Janin on the sideline to Thorne. Lamar with the disc. Breaks all the way across to DiGirolamo. Haas. Thorne, Lamar, really doing a good job swinging it across the field and then getting upfield. That time, the hammer swing to Haas. Lee with the disc. Breaks it upfield, finds Haas. And Haas going all the way around. Some players there, and DiGirolamo.
Look what I found.
Woo. Picking it up through the crowd. Great poach from Ben Laurie coming off his defender on that dead side. It must have been the gloves, though. DiGirolamo.
Stuck right in there.
Oh, wow. Interesting turn of events. It looks like the disc is back at Tommy Lee, which leads me to believe it is a contested stall. It was a high count as he broke it up line to Philip Haas. So that negates the catch. On the play in the end zone, Riley Meinerschagen gets injured. He takes a sub, so a lot of action in a short amount of time. Jacob Janin catching it between the crowd. Disc gets tapped back in. Camp up to Lamar. Haas.
DiGirolamo does not like the pick call. Players are trying to reason it out. Disc is going to go back, though. Getting a little chippy here in the end.
In a high-intensity game.
DiGirolamo, no, he does not like that.
High-intensity game, I'm not all that surprised. For the most part, it has been picks and things which aren't major calls, but definitely slowing down the pace of the game, and that just floats.
Matt Malius heads up D. That's huge.
Rhino defense, a chance to go up too late in this game would be huge. Malius with the disc. Dumps to Bjorklund. breaks all the way around to Friedman, Supnik. And Supnik going deep. Miscommunication with Malius, and unfortunate, Supnik gives it right back.
Second time late in this game that Supnik, crucial point, has turned it over. I've noticed over the years, I played with Supnik for a couple years on Rhino, that his flick tends to come out really hot. Doesn't have a ton of touch on it. He can throw it a mile, but right there you need a 40-yard inside-out float. Just came out a little too hot. Now Jacob Janet on the sideline.
Seven yards to go. Lamar getting it under. Camp loses his defender.
We have an injury called. Jacob Janin calling injury, calling Nick Lance in for him.
Janin has had some muscle problems. It looks like he'll run over to the sideline to try to roll that out. Lance with the disc. Great defense from Rhino, really containing the deep look, which has been deadly out of the NexGen offense.
Tyler DiGirolamo has been open all point long. It doesn't matter who's guarding him. They cannot stay with him. Truly the next generation of ultimate athlete. As you said earlier, Topher, I like to think it has something to do with those gloves.
Great snag from Tommy Lee. Quick dump.
He's methodical with his throws.
Camp gets open underneath.
Alex Thorne guarded by Seth Wiggins. Nick Lance roasts up line.
Round to Haas, he's gonna go all the way across the field. Observers calling that disc down. Unfortunate for NexGen, and now Rhino, second chance to break, to go up too late in the game. Wiggins takes the dump to Malius. And a mental error from Seth Wiggins. There was a call in the field, but you have to keep the disc in possession because there's one continuation throw.
He just took his eyes off it. Just clearly takes his eyes off the disc. Doesn't realize you need to catch it.
And NexGen attacks quick, getting across the field. It's Nick Lance with the disc. Long point for the NexGen offense. And a hammer to Colin Camp. Bjorklund is there.
Colin Camp with the pancake and the edge down spike. Pancake, clap, catch. He was dropping that all tour long last year. This year, not so much. That's a big point for NexGen. They tied at 13s. They could have been down 14-12. You got to put Chris Kotcher in right here. Chris Kotcher, Dylan Freechild, Will Driscoll.
You see Janin coming back on the field. There is call of the soft cap going on soon.
In 8 minutes, it's 9:22 right now. That'll be at 9:30.
NexGen does not want to be in a situation where they're at Universe with Rhino.
No, they don't. It's exactly what they don't want. If anything, NexGen wants to get a break here and then get another break and end this game right now. If it gets to Universe, Rhino is experienced.
NexGen, a few close games so far in this tour. At the end, they had a tight game with Ironside, tight game with Pony to the end of it. But other than that, they've mostly been in control of the game. We will see how they respond at 13-13. Rhino offense.
Sticking with their handlers. Next gen playing excellent downfield defense.
Upfield to Mario O'Brien, and O'Brien goes deep, looking for Jeremy Meyer. Finds him.
Meyer's been playing big for Rhino this game.
Christopher Hancock up to Meyer. Allison Hall is there, but can't make the play.
Where is this guy from?
That is, you might have seen 2-3 hucks from Rhino earlier this game. Through this entire game, we've talked about how they are the team that will take the under. They definitely like to move the ball around with their handlers, getting it wide across the field and then attacking the sidelines. And late in the game, putting the nail in the coffin with a deep look. And at 14-13, Next Gen is in a must-score situation.
On the line for Next Gen, we have Tommy Lamar, Colin Camp, Eric Johnson, Jimmy Mickle, Tyler DiGirolamo, Alex Thorne, and Tommy Lee. Ben Laurie with the pull. Crowd's getting really into it. Big old when I root for the defense cheer.
Junk look from Rhino.
Now they're reeling in.
Wow, a lazy throw. Seth Wiggins.
That's the game, folks.
What
an ending.
Ending.
Are you kidding me? When did that happen? Seth Wiggins. He's a little bit older than these guys, but clearly just as athletic. Huge win for Rhino. Their first win this season, not at Universe.
Taking down the All-Stars.
After they just beat world champion Revolver.
What
wow.
A game here in Portland.
I'm almost speechless. That's what Seth Wiggins brings to Rhino. He brings that exact play right there. He's going to be the one making the big plays at the end of the game, throwing the assist for the win. That is huge. They are fired up. I think we're looking at a contender. Definitely a contender in the club scene. Rhino going 6-1 at ECC, then beating the College All-Stars 15-13. It's their first game. They didn't really have any excuses for this one. There was the game in Boulder. That was their first game, so it's understandable that they lose. The other game they lost was to Ring. There were sprinklers on the field. They didn't eat all day. They didn't have a chance to warm up. Thunderstorm delays. They ended up losing 15-12. And then, of course, they tied Chain Lightning in Atlanta. So we don't really know the result of that one.
And here, Rhino getting a big win in front of their home crowd.
They brought their A game today.
Gotta
feel a lot better today than it did 1 year ago when they played. Losing 15-7 to a bunch of college schmucks.
We're excited to see how Rhino does at Labor Day.
Of course, Next Gen will be covering that tournament, so I'm sure we'll be covering at least one of their games.
Next Gen tournament coverage and tour coverage sponsored by Discraft and Patagonia, Elemental Technology, making the live stream happen. We'd like to thank our cameramans for this game, Brian Bedord and Phil Rennick. Observers, Patrick Buremeyer and Andrew Buremeyer. Of course, our two all-stars in the booth, Kimber Coles and Vin Bowie. Jackson Kelsey, here with me. As for myself, I'm Topher Davis. Be sure to watch NexGen as they go up to Seattle to take on Sockeye on Wednesday.
Wednesday at 7:30.
Tune in then. Great game here in Portland. Exciting finish. We had a lot of fun watching it and producing it. We hope you did too. But now it's time to leave. Vin, take us out.